All right. For this adventure, let's go to the Dominican Republic. All right, so how well do you know the Dominican Republic, or the República Dominica? Well, it's a country located on the island of Hispaniola in the Greater Antilles of the Caribbean region. It occupies the eastern 5/8 of the island, which it shares with Haiti, making Hispaniola only one of only two Caribbean islands along with St. Martin that is shared by two sovereign states. The Dominican Republic is the second largest nation in the Antilles by area after Cuba with 18,792 square miles.
Where am I at? No, where am I? No, I'm in PUJ,
Punta Cana, Dominican Republic.
Punta Cana, what can I tell you? Great food, awesome beers, but it's a resort town in the easternmost region of the Dominican Republic. And much to my surprise, it's the second most popular tourist destination in Latin America with more visitors than any other city in the Caribbean region. And as you can see here, they are ready for Christmas. Now, Punta Cana wasn't developed until the late 1960s, 1970s, with the Punta Cana International Airport inaugurated in 1984. In the Caribbean region, República Dominica is the third largest by population, with approximately 10.7 million people, with whom approximately 3.3 million live in the metropolitan area of Santo Domingo. The Dominican Republic has a tropical rainforest climate in the coastal and lowland areas, and some areas of the region have a tropical savanna climate. Due to its diverse topography, the Dominican Republic's climate shows considerable variation over short distances and is the most varied in all of the Antilles. And as we head north, you can see the many sugar plantations in the savannas, which are very common over here. There are four major rivers that drain from the numerous mountains of the Dominican Republic. The Yaqui del Norte is the longest and most important Dominican river. And the largest lake is Lake Anguilo, a salt lake, which is 148 feet below sea level, the lowest elevation in the Caribbean. In the Cordillera Central, or the Central Mountain Range, you can find the four highest peaks in the Caribbean, Pico Duarte at 10,164 feet above sea level, La Colina at 10,151 feet, La Rosilla at 10,003 feet, and Pico Yaqui at 9,055 feet. I mentioned that the Dominican Republic is the second largest island in the Greater Antilles after Cuba, with the Atlantic Ocean to the north and the Caribbean Sea to the south. It shares the island roughly at a 2-to-1 ratio with Haiti. To the north and northwest lie the Bahamas and the Turks and Caicos Islands, and to the east, across the Mona Passage, the U.S. Commonwealth of Puerto Rico. The Dominican Republic's capital and largest city is Santo Domingo, which is on the southern coast, and also that's where we're currently headed. Now, going way back into history, the native Taino people inhabited Hispaniola before the arrival of the Europeans. The Tainos also inhabited Cuba, Jamaica, Puerto Rico, and the Bahamas. Christopher Columbus landed here on his first voyage in 1492, and then in 1496, Bartholomew Columbus, Christopher's brother, built the city of Santo Domingo, which is Western Europe's first permanent settlement in the New World. The colony was the springboard for further Spanish conquest of America, and for decades, the headquarters of Spanish power in the hemisphere. In 1697, Spain recognized French domination over the western third of the island, which became the independent state of Haiti in 1804. Here's where it gets complicated. After more than 300 years of Spanish rule, the Dominican people declared independence in November of 1821. The leader of the independence movement, José Núñez de Cáceres, intended the Dominican nation to unite with the country of Gran Colombia, but the newly independent Dominicans were forcibly annexed by Haiti in February of 1822. In independence came 22 years later in 1844 after victory in the Dominican War of Independence. Over the next 72 years, the Dominican Republic experienced mostly civil wars and several failed invasions by its neighbor Haiti, and a brief return of Spanish colonial status before permanently ousting the Spanish during the Dominican War of Restoration from 1863 to 1865. Here's where it's totally fucked. During this period, three presidents were assassinated. José Antonio Salcido in 1864, Ulysses Horiaux in 1899, and Ramón Casáceres in 1911. The United States occupied the Dominican Republic from 1916 until 1924 due to threats of defaulting on foreign debts. And then from 1930, the dictatorship of Rafael Leones Trujillo ruled until, well, his assassination in 1961. Juan Bosch was elected president in 1962, but was deposed in a military coup in 1963. A civil war in 1965, the country's last, was ended by U.S. military intervention and was followed by the authoritarian rule of Joaquin Balaguer in 1978. Since then, the Dominican Republic has moved towards representative democracy and was first led by Leonel Fernandez. Holy shit, that was a mouthful. Speaking of mouthful, we really came for the mofongo and the mondongo soup with some ice-cold beers. Yeah, well, I bet you are. Salsa and merengue. It's a great night. Ended up at the La Cacta Brewing Company. I bet you can't guess what that stands for. If you guessed spider, then you are correct. And tonight, we go see the baseball. December 1st, and a perfect night for some Dominican baseball. Baseball, Dominica. La boleta mía se me barata hoy. Sé que tú no quieres, here's an uninterrupted look into the sights and sounds of the stadium. Stadium is it's shared by two teams. Let's take a look at Escondido and some players that you might recognize that played for this team here in Dominican Republic.
All right, how about Alou? Remember the Alou? Felipe Oasis, Montreal. Sammy Sosa, he's a weirdo now. Felipe Alou up there, Montreal. How about Tito Fuentes? Remember Tito Fuentes? How about, let's see, Sterling Marte played for the Mets this past season. Tim Wallach. Tim Raines from Montreal Expos. Remember him? How about A-Rod? There's a young Alex Rodriguez playing for Escondido. Ken Obergfell won a World Series with St. Louis. Fernando Tatis Jr. playing now. So anyway, here's the Wall of Fame, the Galleria de la Fama for Leones. That started in 1921, this team, actually. So, there's Leones.
So the other half of the stadium is dedicated to another team called Licey, and this is their wall of fame right here. As you can see, they're not as famous, but this is their wall of fame, the Licey Wall of Fame. Remember how I told you the stadium is shared by two teams? This is their wall of fame right here. December 1st, and I'm watching baseball here in Dominican Republic, Santo Domingo.
Aquí tomorrow, desde Santo Domingo, and baseball. I want to introduce mi amigo Giancarlo.
We're going to talk Dominican baseball quickly.
So, Giancarlo, tell me about Dominican baseball. How many teams are in the league?
Well, actually, for you guys to know, Dominican baseball is our heart. We put everything in it, and we're based on, it's a winter league baseball league. It usually starts around mid-October, and it ends at the end of January.
Okay,
the
final. End of January, okay.
So it's based with 16.
Miren, para que ustedes entiendan la pelota dominicana. Si las estrellas pierden, se cambian para los toros. Si los toros pierden, se cambian para las estrellas. Si el escogido pierde, se cambia para el Licey. Si los gigantes pierden, se cambian para las águilas. Si las águilas pierden, se cambian para cualquier equipo que vaya en contra del Licey. Y si el Licey pierde, se cambia para cualquier equipo que vaya en contra de las águilas. ¡Esto no tiene madre!
The 16, they play 50 games to the end of December. Then the playoffs start on a round robin format. With 14, two teams get eliminated in the semi. Then we go to round robin, which is major. They play 18 games. Then we go to the final, and the final is a 9-game final. The 3D place where we have to do a final with 9 games.
9-game final. Can you imagine a playoff series, 9 games? A 9-game playoff series.
So again, start in October, right when Major League Baseball is ending. And then it finishes right when spring training almost starts.
Basically, that's
it. Go get it.
So it starts and ends like right
before spring training starts. And usually the big leaguers, because we got a lot of big leaguers.
Major leaguers coming
they
down.
They integrate at the beginning of November. They usually take 2 to 3 weeks off, then they become in November, and that's when the leagues get hot and all the teams get beating all everything.
Who is your favorite team? What team you support? You're fanatic.
I'm a big fanatic. I've been a season ticket holder for the last 17 years, and it's called the Tigres del Licey. In English, it's called Tigers.
The Tigres.
So we got 6 teams over here. Our biggest rivalry is Águilas Ibaeñas, the Eagles. They're the yellow team.
Okay.
We got the red team, which you are watching today, which is the Leones del Escogido, the Lions.
Yep.
We got the green team, which is called the Estrellas Orientales, the Oriental Stars. That's from San Pedro, eastern part of the island.
Okay, see.
Then we got the Toros, the Bulls, which is the orange team. They're nearer to Punta Cana. They're in a city called La Romana, you might know.
Okay, yeah, La Romana.
And then the last team, we got the Giants, which is the one that
Gigantes.
Another team from the northern part of the island.
Okay, so season ticket holder, 17 years. He is, Giancarlo is Bills Mafia here in Santo Domingo.
So if by now you're wondering, who the fuck is this guy? Well, he's considered baseball royalty here in this stadium. Los Fanáticos Giancarlo, seen here on local television being interviewed about being back in the stands after COVID and how much he missed baseball.
We're not even close, but we are the loudest team here. It's loud. What you refer to, because we don't fight.
No.
We're humble.
Okay.
We try not to fight, but we get drunk.
Just like Bill's Mafia.
Yeah.
So there you have it, in a nutshell. Mi amigo, muchas gracias for this. Seriously.
And tonight we will enjoy a little more of Dominican baseball.
Talk about a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to hang out in the Dominican Republic and watch December baseball and meet really cool people like Giancarlo. Talk to me all night long about how it works.
So, Giancarlo, tell me about who is Juan Marichal. Tell who is that?
Juan Marichal is the first Dominican Hall of Famer. It's the most famous baseball players that we have. We only have four. Remember, we got Juan Marichal, we got David Ortiz, we got Pedro Martinez, and we got Vladimir Guerrero. Next time, we're going to get Pujols, so it's going to be five.
Five will be Pujols. But now, if you look at the stadium right here, the stadium is named after Juan Marichal. Okay, 4-for-4, uno más cerveza! Jose Bebe!
Baseball or baseball, it really doesn't matter. All I know is that I had another awesome experience meeting new people, eating kick-ass food, and enjoying sports in another country. Gracias especiales, mi tres amigos. Edward Rodriguez, para hacer funcionar la cámara. Mi Gary Espirda, Miguel Puntil. El Giancarlo Hernández, por el conocimiento de béisbol.